The root cause of sciatica is compression. The cure is decompression. There are different treatments that people commonly try to decompress: inversion therapy, physical therapy exercises, massage. It may give you some pain relief, but the problem is not getting fixed. You're not fundamentally changing what is causing the compression in the first place. So even if you get temporarily decompressed and you see some relief, you're just gonna keep coming back and you're gonna be reliant on continuing to use that because you're not fundamentally changing the geometry of your structure and you're not changing the behavior that's causing the compression in the first place. Aside from doing the movements that we're going to teach you, you need to pay attention to how you stand and how you sit. It's not that sitting is necessarily the enemy. Obviously, it's better to move more, but at least when you're sitting, you should sit in a way that keeps your system as decompressed as possible so that you're not contributing to the compression that's causing the sciatica pain. Sitting on the ground properly would be better and working towards that, and the movements we're going to teach will help you to get there. Most people, even if I recommend to sit on the ground, they're going to sit in a chair anyway, and maybe it's just not avoidable because they might work in an office or something. So I'm just going to try to give as practical a solution as possible. If I'm sitting on a chair, I don't want to be in a position where my chest and my ribs are over or behind my hips. I want to be in a position where my hips or my butt is as far back as possible behind my ribs and chest. Avoid sitting in a wide stance, which is going to contribute to the compression in the hip area. You want to basically keep yourself as long and narrow as possible. So you're going to keep your feet closer together and straight, and then you're going to sit with your hips back and with a kind of a forward lean in your torso. Between your tail and your head, you're trying to create as much space as possible. Keep the natural curve in your spine. You don't have to be rigid and try to keep a straight spine. Let the natural curve happen, but just let it decompress. This is going to be more beneficial for your issue than sitting how most people sit, which is something like this, or in a state that compresses everything. Now, the same principles apply when you're standing. When you're standing, keep your stance narrow, keep your feet straight, and keep your hip and your butt behind your chest and ribs. In the beginning, it'll feel like you're sticking your butt out, which is fine, because the feeling you want is, let's say you're standing up to a kitchen counter. Most people, when they stand, they'll be in a forward state where their hips are basically so much forward that they're resting on the counter or touching the counter, but they should be pulled back several inches. So even if your feet were right up to the counter, your hips should be back so that they're not up against the counter. Basically, you want to keep your hips, when you're standing, directly above your ankles. For most people, their hips are sitting in front of their ankles when they're standing on a regular basis because they've been pulled into that state. It will feel for a while like you're sticking your butt back, so do that. It's fine. It'll contribute to more decompression. The problem with a lot of the stretches that I've seen prescribed for this kind of thing is that the stretches are trying to target areas as opposed to just keeping the body in a geometrically congruent state and then stretching out the body. So like when a cat gets up or your dog gets up and stretches out and yawns, it's not trying to stretch its hip flexor or its hamstring. It doesn't even know what that is. It's just lengthening the body. So this is what you're trying to do. You're not trying to target any specific muscle, because as far as the body is concerned, it's just one muscle, all connected. The first movement that you can do is just leaning against a wall and creating decompression. You're just gonna sit against the wall with a narrow stance, with your feet straight, and it's okay to have your heels on the ground, but don't be on your heels, like all your weight on your heels. Try to keep just a light pressure on your heels and most of the weight towards the balls of your feet. And you're going to stick your hips way back, lengthen your spine, but keep your head up. So your sternum or your chest should basically be pointing at the ground. You're not like this. Basically pointing at the ground, lengthen as much as possible. And then you can drop your knees out and kind of sit into it. And you can drop your knees a bit more. You can rest your elbows on your knees like this if you want. and you're just going to spend some time there. This is going to be probably fatiguing your lower back after a while, which is good. It'll strengthen it, but you can use the wall for support. It's kind of like if people are in tune with their body and then they experience a back pain episode, they'll kind of do that anyway. You'll see people go into a posture like this because they're just intuitively trying to find space in the system. So that's basically what you're doing, but you're doing it on purpose and you're doing it preventatively and you're doing it in a way that's gonna build some strength at the same time. You can stay here for 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes, up to 6 minutes, up to 10 minutes after a while, and just build up strength and build up comfort with your hips playing way back behind your ribs and your chest and being in a decompressed state like this. So that's the first exercise. We'll call it wall sit. The base position you want to be in is your sternum is pointing at the ground, your head and your eyes are up and forward, your knees should be directly under your hips, your wrists should be directly under your shoulders. So basically like a table to start off, and your big toes are pointing towards each other. Your heels are dropping away from each other. From there, you're just gonna take one step, like if you're crawling on your hands and knees, it's a contralateral step. So if my right hand goes forward, the left knee goes forward, and then there's a little bit of spine bend as I shift into this column of my body, where my face lines up with my knee, basically. So now I'm just gonna lengthen that a bit. So I'm gonna cross my foot over a bit and slide the back foot back a bit. So this will resemble what people would call a pigeon pose or a pigeon stretch. It will start to resemble that, but instead of trying to get my shin going completely horizontal and then my spine being more stiff and in the middle, I want to mimic like I'm crawling and then just lengthen that position. Take one step, lengthen it. This foot comes across. Now the top of this foot should be pressed firmly against the mat. And from here, you can just slide the back foot back and you should feel it in the left, if I'm on the left side, the left back pocket is where you're feeling it. And you're just gonna rock back and forth. You can rock and then after several rocks, you can just hold it and try to slide your foot back as far as you can. You can kick the back foot up so it's hovering off the ground if you have enough length, and that'll give you more of a strengthening effect as well while it's giving you a lengthening effect. So you can just play around in that spot and then make sure you do it on the other side as well. I'm taking a step like if I'm crawling, like a baby crawl, and then I'm just gonna cross my shin over a little bit at an angle, slide back, keep the same geometry. So now my face is lined up with this knee, and you can pulse or rock there. You can pulse with the leg off the ground, and you can slide back. Make sure that the top of this foot, particularly the area above the outside edge of the foot, but at the top. So make sure it's pressed firmly against the ground and then you decompress in that state. Okay, don't turn it into a pigeon stretch, don't turn it into a static, like isolated stretch. You use your whole body as one piece. It should mimic the crawling pattern. So if I came out of it, I can go right into my next crawling step. Okay? So let the spine bend naturally and let everything line up, let the joints line up so you're geometrically at ease in the body so that the joints can have space and decompress instead of forcing a stretch, which is gonna have the opposite effect that you want. So this is super simple. There's no need to overcomplicate it. The devil is in the details though. The fundamental principle is geometry. You're trying to find space and create space in the system because like I said in the beginning, the root issue is compression. So even if you're using some of the short-term treatments in the meantime for some more immediate relief, you need to do something like this where you are training your body to operate in shapes that keep you decompressed. Because it does no use to go do a stretching session or to go and get a massage or an inversion therapy and then immediately go back to the same behaviors and the same geometry that is causing the compression, because it's just going to creep back in. So you're training your body to move in a decompressed state and to rest, sit in a decompressed state. And so basically you just want to keep, it starts with the length in your spine and keeping your hips in a position that's not pointing forward in relation to your ankles, but directly over your ankles and even behind if you're doing something like sitting or moving forward. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments below. We'll try to answer any genuine questions. If you like this video, please like it and subscribe, because that helps us to continue making more videos that are practical and helpful. Thanks for watching. Please remember that this is something that's intended to help anybody who just watches this video who has sciatica pain or has been diagnosed with something like that. So it's universal enough, it's basic enough that it should help anyone get started with something practical. If you want more individualized help, then I also do individual video assessments. There's a link below, you can click it, fill out the form, and then maybe we can work together in a more one-on-one, more customized scenario. We might release a routine in the future that addresses sciatica, a lengthier routine. There will be a link below that you can add your name to a waitlist. Now I have to film some other videos, so peace out.